child's perspective, time stretches out, you know. We don't have as much of a sense of time as speakers here. We know approximately how long 2 minutes is, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 7 minutes, etc. But a kid doesn't. Not really. They can get lost watching dust bunnies across the floor, you know, just living in the moment. That's a good thing. So I think that's part of why summer seemed to last forever, although truly it was longer. Schools, in an effort to keep students learning, really have added time to the calendar, the school calendar. There are so many minutes that must be instructional time every year. And for the San Juan School District, they have added in weeks for bus maintenance in the winter, for President's Week. Students get the 2 days that they traditionally would get, plus 3 in-service days for the teachers. So that was a good time to take the buses in for servicing. Good sense. It was midway through the year. It was a good idea. We still have it. We still, San Juan takes a whole week off at Thanksgiving, which is nice, but takes time away from the summer. They still only have 2 weeks of Christmas holiday time frame. Spring break moves around, and there are assorted other days sprinkled in. They're considering changing the calendar a bit to get some of summer back now. It won't be until about 2019-20, school year. So we will see how that turns out, but by then I'll only have one kid left in school. My son's a senior this year, and our daughter just started as a freshman. So maybe her last year, I think, or maybe second to last year, she'll possibly have a longer summer. But by then she'll probably have a job and things to do, and so, you know, those long lazy days of summer, I think, are probably not going to materialize from either way. But they do enjoy summer. That's anyway. Carl?
Thank you.
When I think about summer, I think about my childhood and what Carl was mentioning, how the summers felt like they were forever. And I remember that. I loved it so much. And as I think I've mentioned, you probably all heard me mention, I grew up in the country, in southern Missouri, and we had 10 acres, and lived next to the National Forest. So I just got a hop the fence and I was in the National Forest. So summer was my time to just explore everything. I was a fidgety kid. I wanted to be outside. I wanted to be doing stuff. I didn't have to make myself sit quietly in a chair. I don't even know what I did. Every day, all day long, outside in the woods. But I entertained myself, and I think I got almost as much of an education from sitting in the classroom. Because I was watching the birds, I was watching the squirrels, I was picking up snake skins, and I just digging for worms, climbing trees. But, you know, I think growing up in the city and growing up in the country have, you know, pros and cons to each of them. But I'm really grateful in many ways that I grew up in the country and I could just wander around and explore. Yeah. Summer was the best time to do that. That's really what I'm doing. Thank you.
I'm just excited about summer. And I'm excited about my kids. I love being a parent, and I love being a parent with a 13 and a 16-year-old. And I've come into this when you're a parent of young children, you're like, okay, I want my kids to have these experiences. I want them to have summer fun. And so my kids did all, for the first 10 years, my kids, you know, we did sports. One summer we did like five sports all together in a year. It was kind of crazy between two boys. But they were in summer camps, and they were, you know, in school camps, and we had reading camps, and we had, you know, the sports camps. And every summer for the past 10 years, they've been super busy. And I've been lucky enough to be able to get them there, to do things with them. But now we're in new beginnings. And I've been like new beginnings. Like, I can't even, I've been like almost an overwhelm over all the new beginnings in the last couple of weeks. With my son getting his license, with realizing that his friends have been getting their licenses, that some of them are working now. Like, they're working like real jobs. Like, these kids who used to be running around and making messes in my house, now they're like working people. And to see them, and to see them alone in a car is like, whoa, like, that was gay. It's like crazy to see these little children now maturing into young adults. And they're so different. And this summer, we did a little baseball, but that was it. A little soccer, but that was it. And I've let them just do whatever they wanted, because we've done so much over so many years. And I know that they're in such a transition right now, that soon they're going to be moving on to even more bigger responsibilities. And I want them to enjoy being kids. And as I have allowed these new things to come in without pushing back and saying, no, not yet, I've realized that the relationship with my oldest son, especially, letting him see his girlfriend as much as he wants to, even though he was gone for 11 days, and then he went to his friend's house for 3 days in Tahoe, and then he came back and wanted to see his girlfriend and didn't want to spend time with me. It's like, okay, like, this is his life. Like, this, he's starting to do his thing. And just to say, because I allowed that to happen and not fight against it, the last few days, as school was beginning to start, I noticed a change in him. And he wanted to be with him. And he was snuggling up to me, and he was saying, thank you, helping me, can I help you, Mom? And I'm like, this is good. But it's been great. So when something new and is shifting, just be open to the possibility of how can I allow this to come into my life and be open with the new change. There you go.
There were a few ums and ahs, you know, everybody had a few here and there, but nothing distracting, which I really think is, with the ums and ahs, what you're looking for. And